In this Google Sheets tutorial, you will learn how to add a checkbox and how to combine formulas with checkboxes. Let's start with how to add a checkbox. To do this, select the cells where you want to add checkboxes, go to Insert, and click Checkbox. The basic thing you need to know about checkboxes is the following dependency. When the checkbox is checked, it returns the value true. When it's unchecked, it returns the value false. If needed, you can change these values by selecting the checkboxes, going to Data, Data Validation, choosing the selected range of cells, and clicking Use Custom Cell Values. Now you can enter custom values, which means you can choose what value the checkbox will return, whether it's checked or unchecked. As you can see, there are also some more advanced settings if you need them. Now that you know how a checkbox works, it's time to learn how to create formulas that use checkboxes. In the first example, there is a list of deals with the amount of money that will be received when the deal is closed. Next to each deal is a checkbox, which shows whether the deal is already closed or not. We want to create a formula that shows the value of all closed deals. So we will use the following formula, equals sum if, and then follow Google Sheets instructions. First, we need to enter the range, which will be the range of cells with checkboxes, then the criterion, which in this case will be true, because when the checkbox is checked, it returns the true value. And finally, we need to enter the sum range, which will be the range of cells with the amount of money. Now let's mark some deals as closed and see if our formula works properly. The formula shows us $3,000 after the deals with values of $1,000 and $2,000 were checked, so everything works fine. Here's another example of how we can combine formulas with checkboxes. In this case, we want to make our table more legible, and we will do it in the following way. When the checkbox is checked, the background of the cells in that table row will change to green. To do this, select the table, go to Format, Conditional Formatting, and choose the option Custom Formula Is. Then enter equal sign, dollar sign, and the cell address of the first checkbox in the table. Let's take a look at how it works. Format cells if equals dollar sign D3. So if the value in this box returns true, then the cells will be formatted. Now, keeping this in mind, let's go through the whole process. If the checkbox in the D3 cell is checked, the cell D3 will return a true value, which means the formula in the box will return true, and the cells will change according to the formatting style. In this case, the formatting style changes the fill color to green, but it can also do other things, for example, making the text bold. We entered dollar sign before the column to lock the column because checkboxes are in one column but have different row addresses. For example, if we lock both the column and row addresses, the checkbox in this one cell will be responsible for whether all cells in the table have a green background, and the rest of the checkboxes won't work. If we lock just the column, each checkbox is responsible for its own row in the table. If you find this tutorial helpful, consider giving it a thumbs up. And of course, if you want to stay up to date with new videos, don't forget to subscribe.